Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's your boy Sean, and I'm coming at you on Urban 420. That's right, this channel is dedicated to cannabis and cannabis-related products. Everything from glass pipes to 18-inch water bongs to oil coils, e-nails, and I've got a really cool product review tonight of another portable wax pen from Yocan. That's right, it's another Yocan review here on Urban 420. If this is your first time here, I just told you what the channel's about. So if you're into that kind of content, then consider hitting the big red button below this video. Go ahead and ring that little bell next to it while you're down there so you can get notified of all my future videos. But tonight's video, and let me rewind. If this is not your first time coming here, then welcome back and thank you very much for coming back to another video. So, back to the topic at hand, the Yocan LIT. That's right, L-I-T. This is the unboxing. Boom, we're not just gonna get right into it, I guess, huh? Anyway, that is a picture of it there on the box. That's the box. You got the Yocan hologram there. Verify your product is real. There's instructions to help you to be able to do so. The Yocan products, they come in these nice packages now. This is your instruction manual, which I've already kind of browsed it. Comes with your charging cable, of course. And this one is the standard micro USB. It's not the... what do you call it? It's not the Type S, because there is the vein, which is the Type S, I believe. And I think that the Yocan X is also a Type S. Yeah, it is. So this one is a micro USB, and it plugs in right up in here. This is the actual device itself. As you can see, it's pretty crafty. It's nice metal construction. All Yocan products are usually. It's got the Yocan logo embossed right there. I'm not sure if you can see that or not from here. What I do like about this is it's five times to turn it on. One, two, three, four, five. And the light is right there in the charging port. And it's got a magnetic atomizer. I'm gonna get into that too. It's really cool. It's got an adapter that allows you to hook up a 510 cartridge too. So anyway, I wanted to point out that you control the voltages with this little knob on the bottom. You dial it like that, and it goes everywhere from, looks like 1.8, and then it goes all the way up to 4.2 volts, or watts, or whatever that is. I think it's watts. And so anyway, you don't have to push the button to change the temperature. You just turn the dial at the bottom. Now, what's cool about this atomizer is just a standard magnetic holder in there, and it's got the little adapter that you can use for a 510 cartridge. And I think I have one here we can try out. But what I've noticed is that your carb cap is built right into your mouthpiece on this. And then it comes with the standard dual quartz coil atomizers. And there's two of them. That's what they look like when they're brand new. I'm not sure if you can see in there, but there's two coils in there. It's the dual quartz coil atomizer, or a quartz dual coil. It's pretty, been around a while, the technology, so. Same technology that's used on all their other pens. They sometimes have a triple coil and a quad coil, but not in this particular package. And then the bottom of the quartz dual coil atomizer already has the magnet built into it. The adapter is only if you want to use it with a cartridge, which we are gonna do that in a minute, but first, let's go ahead and load this sucker up with some wax. I've got some actual true wax here, which is from a Florida dispensary. I know that people will be watching this video all over the world, but this particular product here is from Florida, Sunshine State. Truly, if you're an investor, check them out. If you live in Florida, go buy some product. I'm just kidding. So we're gonna be putting a little bit of wax here inside the atomizer, and I just kinda, for this wax, I just kind of smear it on the side, and then I just kind of push it down. And if it wants to stick back onto your dab tool, what I do is lick my fingers like that, and then I roll it into a ball, and it usually just drops right off my fingers like that. And if that doesn't work, then you can just kind of push it off with your dab tool gently without trying to get it stuck to your dab tool again, which it's doing to me. So it doesn't always work out in your favor, but you gotta give it a shot. There you go, perfect drop. So, I've got the wax sitting right on top of the coil in there. I'm not sure if you can see that. And then we put the top back on it, which already has the carb cap built into it. It's got the mouthpiece there. It's nice, like a chrome construction. Drop that down in there. It's magnetic. So just drops right down in there. And then you've got your little button there. It's kind of like a clipper lighter in a way. That's what it kind of reminds me of. I'm going to go ahead and, whoops, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to turn it on. I guess I had it on and turned it off. So now it's on. Here we go. Did have pretty good airflow. Like I felt a lot of, like I'm not having it on right now, but I'm just showing you how, I don't know if you can hear it, but it seems like it has really good airflow. And I see these two little cutouts over here. I'm assuming that, oh, I just noticed too, it says lit right there on the actual battery itself. The flavor is pretty good. I believe I have it set all the way down to the lowest setting, which is 1.8 watts. So let's go ahead and bump that sucker up to three. No, I'm gonna use my light here to read it. Okay, it's 2.7. There's 3.2. Let's try 3.2 this time. And I'm gonna do it like this so you can kind of see it. Well, that's what I was trying to do before, is to try and hold it in a way so you can see it. I think if I do it like this, and you can see the device. Not that that's important, but I just like to show off products when I'm showing them off and doing a review. So here we go with the lit. Hit number two at 3.2 watts. The higher wattage definitely gets you more vapor, as you can see. Flavor is still pretty good. I really like the quartz taste. They do make ceramic atomizers too, and the walls in here are ceramic, but they also make a ceramic disc or donut type of a coil. Yocan does. And I do like that one. I use that particular one on the Yocan torch. I use the ceramic one for that. But I do like the quartz too for good vapor production, because I just think they heat up fast and they really kind of cook your waxes or your shatters. That was at 3.2 watts. I'm impressed with it. Is that 70% the light is white, which right now the light is still white. Okay. Oh, it's actually blinking. If it's blinking, I think that means that it needs to be charged, but we're going to find out. Oh, no, that's because I have the atomizer out. My bad. So white means 70% battery charge. Blue means 30% battery charge. Well, 30 to 70%. And then when it's red, it's less than 30%. You need to charge it. So let's see if it tells me in here the size of that battery. I like to know that, and I like to put that in my reviews. It's adjustable from 1.8 volts to 4.2 volts, and it will run for 10 seconds, it says. Interesting, that's a little bit longer than the other 7 seconds that I've seen on other vape pens. Anyway, I do believe, I'm going to put it in the description, but I know that it's at least a 400 milliamp hour battery. So that should last you, you know, for definitely a couple good sessions. This isn't something that you sit around and smoke with your friends with. None of these portable, you know, wax pens or anything from Yocan. I've got the Yocan X here. We've got the, one of my favorite products right here is the Yocan Vane. That's a dryer vaporizer. It competes with the G-Pen Splash, I believe it's called, or whatever that thing is called. But anyway, what else? Oh, the Yocan Evolve. Then I have the Yocan Armor. So anyway, none of these devices are for you to sit around and have a big smoke session with your friends. They're so that you can wax, or you can consume your concentrates, waxes, oils, shatters, crumbles, on the go or in a convenient manner in and around your house. Like, this is great for me when I'm watching a movie with the fam. I can just, you know, step into the bathroom, take a quick little hit, and then go back into the living room. I don't have to, you know, go to the garage and heat up a torch and banger, or even if it's an e-nail, you know, I don't have to do all that.
So, it's very discreet.
Bam. That's that part of it. Now, let's go ahead and take this adapter. I'm going to put it on this 510 cartridge here, like I was telling you earlier. Bada bing, bada boom. Cover my wax back up. Should always keep your concentrates sealed from the elements, because it's the air that makes your concentrates deteriorate. So here we go. Now we've hooked up the magnetic adapter. I screwed it right onto the bottom of my standard 510 cartridge. Drop that sucker in there, and here we go. Okay, my cartridge is clogged. I'm still at 3.2 volts. Here's a trick. Clog cartridge, tap it upside down a few times, and try it again. There we go, banana kush. It's a good flavor too. So you've got a magnetic adapter. Boom, drop in your 510 cartridge of any flavor that you'd like. You can even get refillable cartridges. They sell them at stores, the same store where you can go and buy this. You might even be able to buy them from Yocan, I don't know. But I'm gonna have a link in my description where you can go and buy this directly from Yocan, the manufacturer. And anyway, I hope that you guys come back. I hope that you guys found this video informative, and I hope that you like the Yocan LIT. Well, I'm sure Yocan hopes that you like it. I hope you like my video, and I hope that you got some value out of it. I think this is a handy little device, and I think that I kind of like the design and everything, and I'm certain that I'm going to use it. So the convenience of being able to use a regular cartridge with oil and then also a wax atomizer is really cool. I like that. And without any kind of further delay, definitely give me a thumbs up if you like this video. And if you haven't hit that red button below the video, go ahead and tap on it, make it gray. Ring that big bell next to it and get notified for any future videos. Stay tuned for my future giveaways. I've got one coming up very soon, actually. Less than 200 subscribers away from another Glass Gang box being given away. Bam! How do you like that? Have a great night and have a great day, whatever time you're watching this. Peace out.